Hello. Yeah, thank you first of all to introduce me, my really long name and even longer name of the university. After this really inspiring speeches, I'm having a hard time to make the first session again. So please don't expect too much. It's more or less a vision. It's I didn't visualize very much yet. So, but I want to give you some thoughts of some kind of my passion I have beside of my work as a professor. So I got to tell some words about our university. The University of Applied Science, Hochschule Makromedia, is part of the Galileo Global Education Network, which has 30,000 students around. And Hochschule Makromedia is presented in Germany and or located in Germany at seven different cities. We have basically management studies as well as creative arts. And in this art department, I'm located, and we are doing a lot of commercial work, like visualizing things, as well as doing a design thinking work. So I may use this. Okay. So the next thing, I want to do a short questionnaire. Who has ever used alternative and complementary medicine of you? Maybe you can help me. So there are a few. Who has doubts about it? Who have doubts about it? It's a similar one. So yeah, that's basically my subject, and it doesn't turn. So, but the facts show different things, that there's a highly growth of, or increase of complementary and alternative medicine, which I will call CAM. And even in the, as we can see at the numbers, it has grown really fast, and it will even grow further. It is belonging, for example, traditional Chinese medicine, as well as herbal medicine or phytomedicine, but also homeopathy. And my vision is to build a portal or a system which, for instance, saves all the old knowledge we really are using for, or which has been around for centuries. But there's a problem also, and as I said, there's a huge interest. I go further a little bit, and even there's, so we have to give some statistic as well. Even the number of employees, there's constantly growing in that field. So also, as you mentioned, in healthcare, there will be a change as well. But also, we can see that young people are connected to more and more technical-based or technical-supported services. So probably medicine will go in this field as well. Maybe it does already. So this may also get along with some ways we can compare to the things which are happening in the internet. So, first of all, different from maybe Web 1 and Web 2 or Web 3, the users are going more for an enlightenment, but also for truth. We don't want our data to be collected, and we are going for self-determination. This also brings another problem, because there's a distrust in pharmacy. Even I don't want to split those medicines. I see them more or less holistic, but the general medicine doesn't see it always that way. So, and that's what is basically the problem from the general medicine. CAM is always criticized not to be evidence-based. So I was thinking, because I'm using it all the time, and I'm really I'm really going for it, and so I was thinking about how can we support this CAM methods and treatments which have been around so long, and how can we teach our children to use it, because I have two children, 11 and 13, and I feel they don't know the plants anymore, unfortunately. Maybe it's my fault. But of course, not a lot of them playing outside, but this old knowledge we have to collect in a way and save, because it's nature-based, and as somebody of you said, the next concepts will be nature-based, not human-based anymore, or not only human-based anymore. So that was a basic question, and so that we don't run into that field, what Aldous Huxley once said. He said, even if it was earlier, that medical research has made such progress that there are no healthy people left. Maybe we could have seen from that guy behind the Japan guy or Chinese guy who has lost the contest. So there are several methods around. I didn't added ethnomedicine or shamanism, but my vision is to collect all of those and give the people a tool to take care about their health. So there will be a lot of requirements, and now we have defined the problems, and then we could go through all those problem solution process we have learned by IDEO in a way. So I did kind of a benchmark, looked around. There are several websites I found in that field. Most of them are not responsive, or some don't even work in an artificial or with artificial intelligence. Like my vision would be to have something like an answering machine instead of a search machine. And I did, as well as a benchmark, also I asked some of those professionals and gained some insights. So somebody told me it's only 5 minutes, I have to hurry up a little bit. And the thing is, so we could find out that basically they wish to support such system with a lot of videos, explanation, visuals, but also with a thing what I call assessment function. Let's say maybe you have used TripAdvisor, and a vision could be that, for instance, a professional practitioner could assess a certain treatment as a good, or as a treatment he has used with many patients and which have helped a lot of people. And that's the exception that all of those insiders told me. It should not be by, it should only be by professionals maybe, because otherwise it could be a little bit different to explain. And also another point which is really important, but is not on my topic list, but it's the legal side of it. I guess you mentioned in your when you start a portal or a company, there are all those legal things, but these legal things are important, but the passion should be the first thing to go for. So we have to take this in account, but it should not be on the agenda at the highest level. So visually, they wanted to have a system which is visually supported by design and which should convince the user experience. And if it comes to the information architecture, it can. There are several books I'm trying to go together with some book publisher who has a great structure already, and maybe we can work together in that field. And of course, the moods and the features have to be done in future. So here are some limitations. I don't want to talk about the limitations too much, so I talk about the chances. The vision is to collect and save worldwide knowledge of natural treatments and drugs, especially to show the connections, because there are connections between Hippocratic medicine as well as TCM, and maybe there are connections with medicine from Africa. I don't know yet, but with such a system, we can maybe show it visually, and the user can decide which kind of treatment he wants to go through. And one point is that the user should know that taking care about his health is better than maybe to go to a doctor. So next will be to create a business plan and maybe found somebody to support this. So we can see many parallels to things going on into the from the web 2 to web 3. Let's say collaborative work. A lot of those practitioners, they wanted to give their information because they mentioned it could be said if their experience get lost because it's experience-based medicine. So they are open to share their information and their experiences they have. And those expert ratings could be interesting. So to bring it in a point back, we have we can come to all those old philosophy from Hippocrates or also from Arthur Schopenhauer. And I got a lot of complaints, and many people told me, oh, no, don't go to Israel, it may be dangerous, and don't be feared. And I would say Israel is also experience-based, and I only can say thumb up, and I had a great time. Thank you very much.